Thanks for joining me today, Michael. I might start with a question about your background. I understand that you've been quite active and involved with the Australian Institute of Project Management and also the Knowledge and Research Council. And I wonder if you can talk to us a bit about that.
Yes, no worries. Great to be here, Michelle. Good to chat. I've first got involved with the Australian Institute of Project Management. I think it was about 1998, and I joined the local chapter council, and I saw it as a way of, I guess, getting a bit more involved, seeing what other people are doing. And there was a bit of a way initially of, making contacts, networking, also, I guess, developing my own skills and knowledge. After a number of years, I think it was early 2000s, I was 2004, I think it was from memory, I was asked to take on the role of ACT chapter president, which I did for a period of 2 years. And by virtue of being the chapter president, you also take on the role of a board director and director of AIPM, which I did. Since that time, I've taken over a number of different roles. I currently chair the AIPM Standards Committee. The Standards Committee is responsible for the development and maintenance of the standards that are used as part of the AIPM certification program. And currently, we've just released the new Standard Certified Practicing Project Executive, or Portfolio Executive rather, CPPE, which I led the development of over the last 3 years. And we are currently developing a competency standard for senior project managers. I also chair the Knowledge and Research Council. The Knowledge and Research Council, or KRC, really has two key goals as part of its remit. The first one is around knowledge capture, and the second is around dissemination. So the knowledge capture is really around accessing and capturing knowledge through the research papers, through books, and all of those sorts of artifacts. And the dissemination is making that information and knowledge available to practitioners and industry in locations and in formats that's accessible. One of the challenges with lots of research that's done by academics and researchers is that it's published in journals, and commonly industry and practice practitioners don't access those journals. The other thing too is it's written in language, in a language that's not necessarily easily transferable into practice, and it also may be something that's not entirely relevant to what's done on the ground day to day. So it's about making that information available in a way that's readable, understandable, any locations that industry and practice can use. In essence, what we are doing is by using that research and knowledge, we hope to actually improve project management practice.
At work, what are some of the differences that you've noticed in terms of how Australia does project management and other countries like China, for example?
Yeah, so I guess one of the advantages and one of the really interesting things about working with these different international groups is that obviously, we learn and deliver projects in a particular way. We learn about project management in a particular way, and we understand what projects are from a particular perspective. But the thing is, as you meet and discuss what projects are, what project management is, and how it's practiced with people around the world, you get to see that there's a number of different approaches, and a lot of it comes back to culture. And there's probably also a maturity is not the right word, but there's probably a difference in maturity of practice as well. And so what we see in Australia is that we've tended to take what's done in the US from a process perspective and what's also done in the UK, and we tend to use those as the basis for doing what we do. Whereas different countries are not as experienced or as further developed or further matured in their practices of project management. So there's differences in the approaches that's used. The other thing too is that culture plays a very big, big role in what happens. And obviously, there's a very different cultural approach and cultural aspects in China, for example, compared to Australia or compared to the US or Europe. So the way that people interact, the way that people behave, the way that people perceive and understand things is very different between cultures. And so I think the thing that I've noticed, and I think why I find all of these international projects really quite interesting, is that you get to see different ways that people conceive and understand and manage projects. And it's not to say that our way is the right way or the wrong way, or somebody else is the right way or the wrong way, but every organisation, every country, every culture has different ways of doing things. And I think when you see different ways of doing things, it helps your own, helps you to think about how things are done, why they're done, and it helps you to see that there's a multitude of ways to manage projects. So that's a really interesting observation, a really interesting thing to see.
Excellent. Well, Michael, thank you very much for your time today, and I look forward to talking to you again in the near future.
Excellent. Thanks, Michelle.
Thanks, Michael.